This video shows how to measure the agent's time in system. You can use this approach to measure the time agents spend on specific operations or certain parts of the process. We'll use the job shop example model. Here, you can see multiple pairs of time measure start and time measure end blocks. The first pair measures the time pallet's weight in the receiving dock and the transfer time to the storage zone. The next pair measures the time pallets are kept on the pallet rack before being processed. Let's extend our flowchart with the time measure start and time measure end blocks to calculate the time a truck spends in the system. The truck behavior is defined by the shipping flowchart. Prepare some place here for a new block to fit in. Drag the time measure start block from the process modeling library pallet to the flowchart and place it before the weight S block. Ensure that both ports of the new block are properly connected. This block defines the starting point of time measurement. Now drag the time measure end block and place it before the sync block. This flowchart block measures the time that agents spend in the flowchart part enclosed within the blocks that we have just added. Select the time measure start block and the properties of the time measure end block. One time measure end block can reference a number of time measure start blocks. With the next step, we'll add a histogram to view the truck's time and system distribution. Right-click the time measure end block and select the Create Chart Distribution option from the context menu. We'll place the histogram below the layout image and resize it. Navigate to its properties, open the Data section, and specify Time in System, Model Time Units in the title field. We're ready to run the model. But before we do, let's enable logging to also obtain the collected statistics in the form of a dataset. Click the Model's Database item and select the Log Model Execution checkbox in the database properties. Run the model and switch to the 2D view area. You'll see the histogram below the layout. Switch to Virtual Time to speed up execution and accumulate data faster. There you go. The histogram now shows the distribution of truck's time in system. Stop the model to observe the collected data in the form of dataset. The log item comprising the model execution logs will appear under the database node upon stopping the model. Expand the log item of the database tree branch. We're interested in just two logs, which are the datasets log and the histograms log. In the datasets log, you can find the data stored in all datasets present in the model. To see only the entries for the dataset collected by our time measure end block, filter the log contents. Click the empty cell below the agent column title, remove the Select All checkmark, and select Time Measure End. Now you can see the individual entries for all the agents who pass through the part of the flowchart enclosed by our blocks, the agent's entry time and exit time. The data displayed by our histogram is stored in the histograms log. Filter the log contents by the time measure end block entries. Here, you can see the probability distribution and the cumulative distribution function values for our histograms intervals. The logs are shown in the read-only mode and cannot be modified, but you can copy the required data into a spreadsheet or any analytical software for further analysis. Thanks for watching. Come back for more AnyLogic how-to videos.